Welcome back, guys, to another episode of Game of Thrones.
Ethan! I couldn't find him. Could you? He hides too well, and if he were smart, he would reveal himself.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. He's just forgotten this is a game.
You found me! Well done, Ryan. Don't worry. It's just a game, Ryan.
A stupid game. I don't like it.
He was worried you were gone.
I thought we'd never find you again.
I'm right here. And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
I wish Mira was here. And Asha. And Roderick.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing and—
Can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Ryan, she's perfectly safe, I promise you.
I don't want Garrett to die either. Maester Ortengren said he got sent to the wall. I'll miss Garrett. He was nice.
He'll be fine. Garrett is smart.
No one will tell me what Garrett did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about you, but I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
Who said they're worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland for one. He says you can't fight very well.
What?
And he calls you a milksop.
Sir Roiland forgets himself. After all, you are the lord of the house now.
He doesn't know me, or what I'm capable of.
What does milksop mean?
I don't know, but I know it's not good.
Ethan, you should let Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword, like a man. He taught Roderick and Asha, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
A lord should know how to fight.
Do you remember when we were younger? When we all used to play here? You, me, Roderick, Asha. We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
We had so much fun. But then, everything changed. Roderick became so serious, the lord in training, and he never smiled anymore. And Asha just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are.
Power changes everything.
I know a lord has many responsibilities.
Advanced warfare taught us that.
You don't need to be like them.
I promise I won't change.
Good, because I'd rather have a brother than a lord.
I'll have to have both, I'm afraid.
But since you're the new lord, you can do anything you want.
I suppose.
Everyone will have to do as you say. So I could have all the sweets I want.
If only it were that simple. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted for once. But Ethan will be a good lord. A proper lord.
As many as you'd like, yes.
Really?
Of course. Why not?
Lord Ethan, you're needed in the Great Hall at once. Quickly, on your feet.
That's crazy, this tiny kid is the lord of this house now. Because his father and older brother both died.
What's the matter?
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced and certainly unexpected. He's come demanding justice.
Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan.
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the lord. We really must go.
It's your decision. You are the lord.
If I were lord, I would command Ethan to stay with his family.
Fine. If that's what's required of me.
Very well then.
Sorry guys, I have to go.
Thank you. They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they're here?
A business with Garrett. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrett is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is, was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any satisfaction. Out there, you were decisive and firm. Now do it again with these bastards.
Let's not do something rash. Things are bad enough as it is.
I can handle Lord Whitehill.
Well said, my lord.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more than he already is. He's got 5 times as many men, and the backing of House Bolton.
All the more reason to stand up for ourselves. Only cowards and dead men roll over.
I'm gonna be ruthless here. Not giving him any ground.
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house. My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself. I've been waiting for this day all my life. The Forresters finally get their due.
My father died a hero, fighting for the North against traitors and oathbreakers.
Aye, and look where that got him. And no bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody amateur. No courtesies. I should have expected as much.
Fetch Lord Whitehill some bread and salt. It was an oversight, Lord Whitehill. I promise it won't happen again.
Not likely. You Foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the North now.
Roose Bolton is the Warden of the North.
Aye. And we've been his bannermen for 5 fucking centuries, you cunt.
Wow, watch your language.
Lord Ethan, you're losing control of this.
That's enough, Lord Whitehill.
I'm not finished! Maybe if you hadn't been so fucking greedy with the ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
This asshat.
Your man, the squire. We were minding our own business. Keeping the king's peace, as his lordship here said, when your man attacked us for no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
No reason? You murdered his family.
Then you admit it was your man who killed my men. And a pig farmer at that. How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan? He acted in your name.
He was defending his family as any man would. But your men murdered them all.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. The soldiers worth 100 of their type. Where's the fucking coward who killed my men? I know he's here. What have you done with him?
We haven't seen him. He was never here.
You little liar. I will find him. By the gods, you better hope I do, because if I don't, I'm holding you responsible. And you'll answer for what he's done.
I'm not leaving until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton.
What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all. But this... this is not over!
It's over when my son says it is.
This is over, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
Damn!
That lad may be lord of this house, but Lord Bolton will have the final say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own, that the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
You're a craven, Lord Whitehill.
I don't even know what that means, but I hope it's bad. We're gonna get revenge on him. Hopefully in the near future.
I was wrong about your son, my lady. He stood up to him like a true lord.
You were brave, my son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you bend the knee.
What does bend the knee
prepare
mean?
Prepare a raven. We need to send word to Mira in King's Landing at once.
I have no clue what bend the knee means. Oh, man. All right, here we go.
Help us. Although just a handmaiden, she has Margaery Tyrell's favor. And Lady Margaery's betrothal to the king may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay. If it's presented to her as it should be.
What's this? An unfinished letter. All right.
Asher sent me this coin to remember him. What a strange place, Essos. Ethan made this for me. It was very kind of Lady Margaery to give this to me. It once belonged to Lady Elena.
I want some of those grapes, man. Those are good.
Wonders Made by Man by Lomas Longstrider. A gift from Roderick. I hope to see them all someday. King's Landing. I wonder if it's sunny at Ironwrath today.
Wow, she's balling out over here. Freaking Oceanside? Oh my gosh, eating grapes? Just chilling. Ooh, letter from Mother.
It troubles me to even ask this of you. But you must appeal to Lady Margaery to intervene on our behalf. She is our best hope, and can be a powerful ally. Especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
Let's see who it is.
One moment.
Oh. Sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
No, it's fine. Come in.
Who is this?
Begging your pardon, m'lady, but you all right? If you don't mind my asking. You seem rather upset.
I'm just worried about my family.
Ah, letter from home, is it?
It's kind of you to ask.
Of course, m'lady. You've always been kind to me.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Margaery will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady. You work for Lady Margaery? I may be wrong. But it seems like you do.
I'm her handmaiden.
That's what I thought. I've seen you with her before. You seem like good friends. I saw Lady Margaery just this morning, outside the Royal Sept, talking to Queen Cersei.
Cersei?
They appeared to be having some sort of disagreement. I couldn't hear much, but...
What did they say?
I couldn't make out much, but I know they were talking about the Starks and House Forrester.
House Forrester?
Oh, shit.
I hope you're not in any kind of trouble. But I thought you ought to know. Most people don't tend to notice a callboy. Not in King's Landing, with so many lords and ladies about. You see and hear all sorts of things when people don't even know you're there. Good night, m'lady.